Hello friends, welcome back to another session. Today's topic is what? Yes, today's topic is wastewater. Sorry, it's going to be an amazing session, guys. Promise, it's going to be an amazing session. So let us start. So first of all, while learning wastewater story lesson, we should know what is wastewater. So do you know, friends, what is wastewater? Do you know? So the water which gets contaminated, okay? So the water, this water is good water, but after we use this water for washing, bathing, mopping, this water will turn into ugly or it gets contaminated. So that water is known as wastewater, okay? So the World Water Day is on 22nd of the March. So now we learned what is wastewater. Now let's look what is sewage. So sewage or domestic or municipal wastewater is a type of wastewater that is produced by community of people. So sewage, it is a type of wastewater produced by community of people, not from one house, not from two houses, but in the community of people. It contains the chemical gases or chemical things, toxic things, and it is mostly gray water. We put it in our sink, right? After bathing our plates, so we will be eating food at the morning, even afternoon and evening. After that, we will wash the plate, and that wastewater, then the water will turn into wastewater. Then that wastewater will go through the sink, and from bathtubs, there will be bathtubs in some home. They will bath in it and shower. There is a shower in my home. It is very, very hard to control. Like owning it, then hot water will come. Then when I am turning on cold water, it will, so much cold water will come. So in my house, the shower is very, very hard to control. So from sink, from bathtub, from shower, from dishwashers, this water will come. So it consists mostly of gray water, okay? Now, what does sewage contain? So I told you animal waste and oil, you know, right? Oil we use in our kitchen for making fried things, and we will eat, yummy, it will be so yummy. And oil and urine and pesticides, herbicides, and fruit too, like rotten fruits we will put in our dustbin or somewhere, and that will also see that will be there in the sewage. The fruit, the vegetable waste, after eating banana, that remaining thing we will put it in the dustbin or something, then that will also be there. And inorganic impurities like nitrates, phosphates, metals, so nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen, bacteria such as cholera, bacteria which can cause cholera and typhoid, and other microbes like such as which cause dysentery. Okay, now what is sewer? So a pipe which carries with the wastewater is called sewer. Okay, so after using this water or your fresh water for bathing, mopping, or something, washing, this water gets contaminated, and that's wastewater has to be carried to somewhere, right? After it is turned into wastewater, that wastewater has to be carried into somewhere, right? So that where sewer comes. So the sewer is the pipe which carries the wastewater. So in the town or in a city, there will be so many sewer. From one home, there will be one sewer. From the second home, there will be a second sewer. And that network of the sewer is known as sewerage. So the network of big and small pipes is called sewerage. Form the pipes called sewers that forms the sewerage. Okay. Now sewage treatment. So it is turned into, from the fresh water, it is turned into wastewater, and that wastewater is carried by sewer, and the network of that is known as sewerage. So after this water has to be treated, right? After the getting this water has to be treated because it is waste. It is harmful for the environment and for us. So the process of removing impurities from the wastewater before it can be reused for like flushing toilets, or they will send into water bodies, is that to send water bodies or for reusing, we have to treat it. Okay, so how do we treat it? So the water goes to a grit and tank, sand removal tank. So the water then goes to a grit and sand removal tank. So grit and sand removal tank, sand it will remove, and the speed of incoming wastewater decreases to allow sand grit to pebbles to settle down. So they will decrease the speed of the water to pebbles, and everything should settle down. Sedimentation and decantation, you know, right? If there is a muddy or some wastewater, we will put it in the glass or some container for some time, then heavier particles will settle down and we will slowly pour it into some other glass, then we will get the pure water, right? So that process is known as sedimentation and decantation. Okay, now water is then allowed to settle in a large tank which is sloped towards the middle. Solid-like phase settle at the bottom and removed with scraper. I told you, right, that things will settle down bottom. Okay, a skimmer removes the floatable solids. Some floatable solids should be there, right? Some floatable solids like what? And bottle and bottle ball, that like and all ball pieces, that and all will float. So a skimmer removes the floatable solids like oil. Oil, you know, right? Oil will not mix with water. It will be upside of the water. It cannot settle down. And grease, that also. So that is as though that skimmer removes it. Okay, so water is so cleared is called clarified water. So then the water is cleared, so that water is known as or is called clarified water. Now the sludge is transferred to a separate tank. After treating it, that sludge is separate that sludge is transferred to a separate tank where it is decomposed by anaerobic bacteria, and the biogas produced in the process can be used as fuel and can be used to produce electricity, guys. Also, okay, so it is used, it can be used to produce electricity too and to make fuel. Sorry, it can be used as fuel. Now air is pumped into clarified water to help aerobic bacteria consume human waste, food waste, soaps, and other unwanted materials still remaining in clarified water. After several hours, the suspended microbes settle at the bottom of tank and activated sludge. Okay, this slide should come before. This slide should come after this slide. Okay, so after water is so clarified water, then the sludge is transferred. This I have already told you. In this, the sludge is transferred to a separate tank. Okay. So then before that there is one process. Air is pumped. Okay, so the air is pumped into the clarified water to help aerobic bacteria to grow. Okay, then that bacteria consume the human waste, food waste, soaps, and other unwanted materials still in clarified water. So that soap, human waste, food waste, and that and all will be eaten by the aerobic bacteria. Then that slab, then the water is then the water at the top is then removed. Okay, now see, the activated sludge is about 97% of the water. The water is removed by sand drying beds or machines. Dried sludge is used as manure to returning organic matter and nutrients to soil. So the treated water has very low level of organic material, so it has the very low level of organic material and suspended matter. Okay, then it is discharged into sea, or I have told you it will be released into water bodies. Okay, now better housekeeping practices. Now let's look at the better housekeeping practices. So the cooking oil and fats should not be thrown down the drain. So the cooking oil I had already told you, and fats should be, it should be not thrown into the sewage because they will get harder and they will block it. Okay, they will get harder and they will block it, and they can be harder. I told you they can be ha get hardened and they will block it. And in open drain, the fats clog the soil pores, reducing its effectiveness in filtering water. So throw oil and fats in your dustbin. We will be using our oil and fats in our kitchen. So kitchen Almost every waste we will put it in the sink. So don't throw oil and fats into sink because they can get hardened and they will block your pipe. So chemical like paint, solvents, insecticides, motor oil, medicine may kill microbes that help purify water. Okay, so do not throw them down the drain. So it will kill. Okay, paints, solvents, insecticides, motor oil, medicine may kill the microbes that help purify the water. Okay, now better housekeeping practices. Second one, use tea leaves and solid food remains, soft toast cotton and sanitary towels, etc. should also be thrown into dustbin. Don't throw them into the sink or the these waste. Just choke the drain, choke, not just block, choke the drains so they do not allow free flow of the oxygen. This hampers the degradation process. Okay, now sanitation. So poor sanitation and contaminated drinking water can cause large number of diseases. So large number of diseases they can cause, and a very large fraction of our people defecates in the open or dry river beds, on railway tracks, near fields, many a time directly in water too, directly in water. So it may cause the water, it may cause the water pollution and soil pollution. So it will cause the water pollution, soil pollution. So both the surface water and groundwater gets polluted. Okay, now moving on, sanitation. So to improve sanitation, low cost on-site sewage disposal systems are being encouraged. So to improve the sanitation, we should improve the sanitation, or our environment will get very smelly and it will get contaminated, or it will get like we can't live in it. So examples, septic tanks, chemical toilets, composting pits should be made in your home. Not chemical toilet and septic tanks, you can make composting pit in your home. Take it as an work for you. You can make composting pit in your home, then you can throw the compostable wastes, like what, the banana. After we eat banana, we can throw it to the composting pit. After some days or after some years, it will be not there, it will be mixed with soil. Okay, so now sanitation at the public places. So in railway station, bus depots, airports, hospitals, large amount of waste is generated here because they use larger electricity and so many people's come and go. So we should not scatter litter anywhere. If there is no dustbin inside, we should carry the litter with us and litter home and throw it in the dustbin. We should not throw at the public. Okay, so that's all for today's session. So how was this session? Comment down below, guys. Don't forget to comment down below and how was it. Don't forget to comment down below how was this session. So see you in the next session. Bye.